Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Design of Transmission Systems. And this is lecture number 7.1. We are going to discuss about the design of bevel gears using the design data book, PSG design data book. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the design of spur gear and helical gear using the PSG design data book and solved problems in the spur gear and the helical gear design. The learning outcome for this lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve design bevel gear using the PSG design data book and solve the problem. Bevel gears have teeth formed on the conical surface and was mostly used for transmitting motion between intersecting shaft. In the earlier two lectures, we discussed the design of spur gear and helical gear. The spur gear, helical gear, both are cylindrical type of gears. So the teeth is cut on the cylindrical surface and they are transmitting power. The spur gear and the helical gear transmitting power between the parallel shaft. Now the bevel gear, they are cut on the conical surface. As you see in the diagram and the animation, the teeth is formed on the conical surface and the shaft of the pinion and shaft of the wheel or the gear, they are intersecting at 90 degrees. So when you extend the center line of the pinion and center line of the gear, they will meet at 90 degrees. That is what the bevel gear. So the bevel gear has teeth formed on the conical surface and the transmitting power between the intersecting shaft. Bevel gears, there are different types: mitre bevel gear, straight bevel gear, spiral bevel gear, zeroed bevel gear, hypoid bevel gear, and the spiroid gears. So this is simple straight bevel gear and mitre gear. So when equal bevel gears having equal teeth and equal pitch angle connect two shafts whose axis intersect at right angle, then it is known as mitre gear. So look at the diagram. So both the gear, pinion and the wheel, both have equal number of teeth and equal pitch angle. They meet at right angle 90 degree, then this type of gearing is called as mitre gear. So here the transmission ratio equal to 1. Now straight bevel gear are usually used for the pitching velocity up to 5 meters per second when the noise level is not an important consideration. So they are less expensive to produce than other bevel gears. So the straight bevel gears are mostly used for transmitting power with the higher speed ratio. The spiral bevel gear, so these are all the spiral bevel gear. So here if you look at the teeth, that is inclined, they are spiral form, are recommended. The spiral bevel gear are recommended for a higher speed and where noise level is an important consideration. Spiral bevel gear are the bevel gear counterpart of the helical gear. So this is very much similar to the helical gear. The helical gear is cut on the cylindrical surface, whereas the spiral bevel gear is cut on the conical surface. The advantages of spiral bevel gear: more number of teeth are in contact at the same time because of the curved shaped contour of the teeth. Smooth meshing action between the gears. Greater contact ratio can be achieved. The noise level is considerably small. Higher transmission ratio can be achieved and greater load carrying capacity. So these are all the advantages of spiral bevel gear. And there is one more bevel gear, zeroed bevel gear, is present, is patented gear of Glaceon Works USA, having curved teeth but with a zero spiral angle. The axial thrust load permissible for zeroed bevel gear are not as large as those for the spiral bevel gear, so they are often used instead of straight bevel gear. So this is what the zeroed bevel gear. So the curve here, again it is curved teeth. Then hypoid gears. Hypod gears are similar to the bevel gear, but the shafts are offset. The tooth action between such a gear is combination of rolling and sliding along a straight line. They are frequently used in the automobile differential gear set. So hypoid gear are used in the automobile differential gear set. The advantages of hypoid gear: smooth and silent running than the spiral gear. Hypoid gear can easily produce large speed reduction. The transmission ratio can be high as 60:1, are quite common here in the hypoid gear, compact comparing with other types of bevel gears. These are all the hypoid gears. So they are offset. So this is the center of the wheel or the gear, and this is the center of the pinion. So they are offset. Then spiroid bevel gear are similar to hypoid gear, but with a larger offset. So you will see the comparison. So look at here. So this is the straight bevel gear, and this is the spiral bevel gear, and this is hypoid bevel gear. You can see the comparison here. So the straight bevel gear, spiral bevel gear, and zeroed bevel gear. So the axis, they are intersecting by 90 degree, whereas hypoid gear and the spiroid gear, they are offset. So when you have lesser offset, they are called as hypoid gear. When you have more offset, they are called as spiroid gear. When the two shaft, the axis of the two gear are not intersecting, then they are called as worm gear. So that we will discuss in the next topic. So the gear, different types of bevel gear, you can see at a single picture here. The spiral bevel gear, straight bevel gear, zeroed bevel gear, the axis are intersecting. The wheel axis and the pinion axis, they are intersecting. Hypoid gear and the spiroid gear, they are offset. When you have more offset, that is called as spiroid gear. When you have lesser offset, they are called as hypoid gear. And in our discussion, we are going to first discuss the straight bevel gear, design of the straight bevel gear. And we will be solving problem on the design of the straight bevel gear. And in the examination, university examination, majority of the question, they will be on the straight bevel gear design. So we will be discussing straight bevel gear, design of straight bevel gear, and solving problem on the straight bevel gear. And the bevel gear terminologies. So look at the diagram. So this is the pinion of the bevel gear, and here is the gear of the bevel gear design. And we have the different diameter, different angle, face width. So we'll discuss one by one. We'll define one by one. This is another diagram of the bevel gear terminology, the different terminology of a particular single gear. And pitch cone. These are cones which roll without slipping when they are in peripheral contact. They are analogous to the pitch cylinder of the spur or the helical gear. So for this pitch cylinder in the cylindrical shape, whereas here in the conical shape, the angular velocity of these cones are inversely proportional to the number of teeth of the bevel gears to which they are correspond. So angular velocity is inversely proportional to number of teeth. Pitch cone angle, the angle subtended at the apex by the axis and the pitch cone generator. This is the pitch cone angle. And the cone distance, the length of the pitch cone generator from the pitch circle to the apex, that is the pitch cone cone distance. And the back cone, the cone generated by a line which is perpendicular to the pitch cone and the generator at a point of the pitch circle, that is what the back cone. So all these details you can see here. So this is back cone radius, and you have addendum. So pitch cone we have, root cone, apex, this is the apex of the pitch cone, and this is the face cone. So all the lines are extended, they are meeting at the center, that is called as apex of the pitch cone. So this is the cone distance, the length is cone distance, and you have the angle. So angle we measure, the angle, and this is the inside pitch diameter, outside pitch diameter, and the radius. Then back cone angle, the angle between the axis and the tip surface of the tooth. It is the sum of the pitch cone angle and the addendum angle. Shaft angle, the angle between the axis of the gear is known as shaft angle. it is the sum of the pitch cone angle and the pinion of the pinion and the wheel. So it is normally 90 degree for the straight bevel gear. Face width, the length of the tooth measured along the pitch cone generator, and virtual number of teeth. So ZB equal to Z divided by cos delta, where delta is the pitch cone angle, Z is the number of teeth on the pinion or the gear. And we have different forces. So this is the bevel gear. So the forces are tangential force, axial force, and the radial force. The normal force acting on the tooth of a particular bevel gear, it is resolved in the three directions: tangential force, axial force, and the radial force. As we are familiar, the axial force and the radial force, they are taken care by the bearings. So the when you design the bearing for any shaft, we'll consider the axial load and the radial load. So the load which is acting in the axial direction of the gear and the radial direction of the gear, that is transmitted to the shaft, and the end bearing will take care of this. They are not giving any useful contribution for the power transmission. So the tangential force, that is what important for the transmitting the power from the pinion to the gear or gear to the pinion. Normally smaller wheel, we know the smaller wheel is the pinion, larger wheel is the gear or the wheel. The strength of the bevel gear tooth given by the modified Lewis equation, Fs equal to sigma b design bending stress b into yv into 1 minus b by r divided by pd, where sigma b is the design bending stress, b is the face width, yv is the Lewis form factor, r is the cone distance, pd is the diametral pitch. And dynamic load on the gear, so fd equal to cv into nsf km into ft, where cv is the velocity factor, nsf is the service factor, km is the load stress factor, and FT is the transmitted load by the gear. So these two are the important forces. There are wear load, everything, but the important for design perspective, the strength of the bevel gear and the dynamic load on the gear tooth. Now we design the bevel gear using the information or the data equations available in the PSG data book. So using the previous equations also we can solve, but the majority of the problem, we solve the problem using the procedure or the data given by the PSG design data book. First you have to calculate the speed ratio. Speed ratio I equal to N1 by N2, where N1 is the speed of the pinion and N2 is the speed of the gear. Then we have to calculate the, select the suitable material for the pinion and the gear from the table 5, page number 8.4, and you take the properties sigma u, ultimate tensile stress, and the yield stress for the pinion material. So all the calculations are based on the pinion dimensions and pinion material, because when you design the parameter for the smaller wheel, so larger wheel will easily accommodate the load. And we calculate the nominal twisting moment to be transmitted by the pinion. So the equation is 97420 power transmitted in kilowatt divided by the speed of the pinion in kilogram 4 centimeter. Then we calculate the design torque. So MT within bracket equal to MT into KKD. Initially we take KKD equal to 1.3. Now this is the table we supposed to refer for selecting the type of material for the pinion and the wheel. And this is the table number 14 for taking the load concentration factor K. And this is the table for 15 for dynamic load factor. So initially we assume KKD equal to 1.3. Later on we take K and KD separately for calculating the design torque once again to check our calculation. Then you take the equivalent Young's modulus from the PSG data book, table number 9, 8.14 page number. So it is directly available. Otherwise, if you know the E1, E2 separate, and then you have to substitute in this equation, you have to calculate. Or you can refer to the material table number 9, and you can take the equivalent Young's modulus from the last column. So for steel combination, steel cast iron, steel bronze, or steel nylon. So majority of the cases we will be solving problem steel or steel cast iron. And we calculate the design surface stress. There are two equations to calculate the design surface stress: sigma c equal to CR HRC KCL or CB HB KCL. where CBC are the coefficients depending on the surface hardness. It is available in the table number 16, page number 8.16. HB is the Brinell hardness number, HRC is the Rockwell hardness number, and KCL is the life factor. It is there in the table number 17, page number 8.17. So this is table number 16. You have to refer for taking CR, HRC, CB, HB value. And this is table number 17. You have to refer for taking the life factor depending on life in number of cycles and surface hardness and the material. Then we calculate the minimum cone distance. R is greater than or equal to psi y I square plus 1 to the power 0.5 into cubic root of 0.72 divided by psi y minus 0.5 into sigma c whole square into e into mt by I, where psi y is the available in the page number 8.15, table number 13. So this is table 13. So psi y r by b value we have to take depending on the I value. So depending on the bearing which is supporting the gear, then we calculate the design bending stress. So, sigma b equal to 1.4 kbl divided by n into k sigma into sigma minus 1 kilogram force per centimeter square. So, all the parameters are we are familiar, because in the spur gear and the helical gear design, we use the parameters. Kbl is the life factor for bending, table number 22. K sigma is the stress concentration factor, table number 21. N is the factor of safety, table number 20. And the sigma minus 1 is the endurance limit stress, table number 19. So, you take all the information and substitute and calculate the design bending stress. Then assuming number of teeth on the pinion Z1, if it is not given, take between 17 and 20, calculate virtual number of teeth. So, virtual number of teeth Zv equal to Z1 divided by cos delta 1, where delta 1 equal to tan inverse of 1 by I. I is the transmission ratio. Then we calculate the form factor from the page number 8.53, table 40. YV, then calculate the average module. So, average module is greater than or equal to 1.28 into design torque divided by YV sigma b psi m into Z1 to the power 1 by 3. Initially, we take psi m equal to 10 for our calculation, then calculate the transverse module. So, mt equal to average module plus b by Z1 sin delta 1, where B equal to R by psi y, and we take the next standard module. So, you have to standardize the transverse module. So, from table number 1, page number 8.2. Next higher value you have to take for module. So, this is the half of the problem, half of the design procedure. Once you fix the module, we have to do our calculation and check for our surface compressive stress and the bending stress. So, this is the table for form factor, table number 40. And this is the table for table 1 for taking the standard module, and to calculate the following parameter. Number of teeth on the gear Z2 equal to I into Z1, PCD of the pinion MT into Z1, and PCD of the gear D2 equal to MT into Z2, cone distance R equal to 0.5 into MT into square root of Z1 square plus Z2 square, phase width B equal to R by psi y or 10 into MT, whichever is smaller. So, here whichever is smaller, and the tip diameter of the pinion DA1 equal to MT into Z1 plus 2 into cos delta 1, and tip diameter of the gear DA2 equal to MT into Z2 plus 2 into cos delta 1. Then now we take the load concentration factor, table number 14, and dynamic load factor, table number 15, for our checking and calculate the design torque MT equal to MT into KKD. So, this is the check design torque for the designed gear. Designed gear, then we have to check for the gear for the compressive stress and the bending stress. Then check for the surface stress. Sigma c equal to 0.72 divided by r minus 0.5b into square root of I square plus 1 to the power 1.5 divided by ib into e into mt. In kilogram force per centimeter square, the value should be less than the design surface stress. And check for the bending stress, sigma b equal to r into square root of I square plus 1 divided by r minus 0.5b whole square into mt by bmyv cos alpha in kilogram force per centimeter square, where alpha is the pressure angle. Normally we take 20 degree, and the value should be less than the design bending stress. These are all the, so we stop here. This is the procedure for calculating the, designing the bevel gear. And after completing all the calculations, you write down the design data, the information about the bevel gear. We stop here. These are all the books I published in the earlier in mechanical engineering, and I upload all the video lectures in the of the subject in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments, and you contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. So thank you once again. We'll meet again in the next video on solving problem in the bevel gear design.